So this is a great poem. And this is a poem that I have lived with and live with very much in my day-to-day. When my sons were growing up, I would exhort them in appropriate moments, conduct your blooming in the noise and whip of the whirlwind. That didn't have a political context. That was always about the things that swirl around us and how you hold yourself together and how you express yourself and how you be yourself when the world around you is challenging you. I think that also to students, I've taught this poem 10 million times, over the years, and to say to classrooms of college students, what does it mean to conduct your blooming in the noise and whip of the whirlwind? What does it mean to come into voice? What does it mean to think about your activism? What does that look like? What are all of the ways that that can look like? I think that thinking about the whirlwind as a perennial state, the political moment in which this was written was different from the political moment that we're in now, but certainly as challenging in the moment to the people who were in it. I think that also what I love so much about Brooks, the peculiarities of her syntax, of her word choices, of her inventions. I don't think anyone's ever written bigly. She stands bigly. But even when you see what it does, when you read it, it makes you plant yourself like Big Bessie, thinking about what it means to say, I am here. The wind will blow me, but I am here. My feet hurt. I've been working, but I am here. So when I read Brooks and when I read her out loud, I think I can only aspire to this. Yeah.